In this video, we back up an Azure File Share. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Seraltos. If you need a file share in Azure, Azure File Shares with SMB support for Windows AD and Azure AD Domain Services is a good alternative to standing up a file server on your own. Azure File Share is a good option for FSLogix Profiles, but whatever data you put out there, odds are it's important. Azure storage accounts offer different levels of resiliency, meaning that they keep a minimum of 3 copies of data in a data center with the option to distribute those copies across different regions. But what if a file in the share becomes corrupt? Azure Resilience does not provide any recoverability of previous versions of files. That's what Azure Backup is for. Before we get started, please take a second to subscribe, like, and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content or when I try going live again. Azure storage accounts have multiple redundancy options, including locally redundant, zone redundant, and geo-redundant options. These options spread copies of the data across multiple systems. However, if that data becomes corrupt, then the corruption is replicated to all copies of the data. Also, if a user deletes a file or just needs an older version of something they saved, by default, that data won't be available. To recover older versions of files, we need to put a backup solution in place. Azure Backup has support for Azure File Shares built in. Backing up Azure files with Azure Backup is a snapshot-based solution. Azure Backup uses the File Share API to trigger and remove snapshots per the schedule. It keeps the metadata about the backup in the Recovery Services Vault, but no data is transferred. This makes for a fast backup solution with built-in alerting and reporting. Keep that point in mind. Azure Backup manages the snapshots. It doesn't copy the data to the vault. In addition to snapshot-based backups, when Azure Backups is enabled on a file share, soft delete on the file share is also enabled. Without soft delete, if a file share is deleted, it's gone. With soft delete, the share is inaccessible when deleted, but recoverable within the retention period. By default, that period is 14 days. This safeguards against the accidental or malicious removal of a file share. This is a share-level property, protecting the share and the files in it, but not the individual files in the share. That's what Azure Backup is for. In order to make this work, we need to first deploy an Azure Recovery Services Vault. This has to be in the same location as the data getting backed up. If you already have a recovery vault in that region, you can go ahead and use that. Then we add a file share to the vault. Once that's in place, we set up a backup policy that determines when the share is backed up and how long the data will be kept. The minimum backup frequency is daily. Retention policies can be applied to the daily backup, weekly, monthly, and yearly backups as well. Let's jump into the lab and do a backup and restore on an Azure File Share. Here we are at the portal. The first step is to create a Recovery Services Vault. This is the central point for backups in Azure. You can skip this step if you already have one and it's in the same location as the items you're backing up. If not, go to All Services and search for Recovery Services. I already have one, but we'll create a new one. Go to Add New Vault. This Recovery Services Vault will have its own resource group. I'll give mine the name Temp RSV RG1. Next, give it a name. Temp RSV1 is what I'll use for my example. And the resource I'm backing up is in Central US, so I'll change my region to Central US, add tags as needed, and then review and create. The deployment finished. Next, let's go to Recovery Services Vault. Select the vault we just created. Before I add anything, I'm going to go to Properties and go to Backup Configurations. And I'll change this to Locally Redundant. Now you can leave it as geo-redundant. This comes down to cost. I don't need the geo-redundancy in the backup data. And matter of fact, if we're just backing up snapshots on the file share, none of that data is getting written to the recovery vault anyway. The important thing to note is you can only change this before you add an item. Once I add a backup item, this will be locked and I can't make any changes. Click Save and Close. Next, we'll go to Backup. And here we're going to add the storage account. We'll leave the workload to Azure and select Azure File Share and Backup. Now I'm going to select a storage account. This is the storage account with a share that I want to back up. I'll add my storage account. Now that the storage account is added, I'll add a share. The storage account only has one share, so I'll select that. Click OK. And next is my backup policy. We can select Create a New Policy. Here we can change the backup policy name, the time, and the time zone. I'm going to change this to Central US. Notice the default frequency for backups is daily. Daily is the minimum reoccurring frequency of the backups. And I'll leave the retention to 30 days. Notice we can set a different retention policy for weekly, monthly, and yearly. We'll leave those blank for this example and click OK. Once finished, enable the backup. We'll give it a few seconds for the backup to deploy. It looks like it finished. Let's go to backup items and see if it's in there. Here, Azure Storage, Azure Files is showing one backup item. There's our share. Notice it shows a warning because the initial backup is pending. Let's go into the backup item and click Backup Now. We'll leave the retention period to 30 days and click OK. That will start the backup. We can also manage backups from the storage account. Let's go into the storage account. Go down to the file shares and select the file share. Notice we have a snapshots and backup option under operations. Go to snapshots. There's the snapshot we just created. From the snapshot, you can navigate through the files and download or restore directly from this interface. If we go back to the share, go to backups, here we have some more options. We can do a file recovery or restore the share. Let's go over to a server and look at this share. Here's the share mounted on the server. Under test users, we have this testdoc.txt. I'm going to delete that. Now I'll go back to the portal and do a file recovery. I'll select my restore point, click select. Here I have the option to restore to the original location or an alternate location. That gives you the option to restore it to a different file share. I'm going to select original location. And in case of conflicts, we have the option to overwrite or skip. I'll leave that as overwrite and add a file. Here we can navigate to the file, select, and then click OK. And restore. We'll give that a minute to run. Let's go back to that computer and see if it's there. Let's go into all users. There it is, the file we deleted is back. That didn't take long at all. Let's go back to the portal. There's one more item I want to go over. Let's go back to the storage account. And under file shares, there's a soft delete option. This is enabled by default when the storage account is added to the recovery services vault. Here we can disable it, or we can change the retention period. This gives us the ability to restore the entire share if the share is accidentally deleted. That's how you backup and restore files on an Azure File Share with Azure Recovery Vault backups. There's currently no charge for Azure Backup for file shares because it's a snapshot-based solution. However, you do have to pay for the snapshots that the solution creates. I hope you found this helpful. If so, please subscribe, like, and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. Thanks for watching.